morning, everyone. My name's Dallas, and I'm actually sentenced to a life sentence with my twin brother John. Anyway, I'll talk about my experiences of photography in my presentation. But for now, I'd just like to direct your attention to this workshops that we'll be running. Actually, this sheet here, and John's actually the master of the Photoshop, so he does most of the workshops. But if you know anyone who's interested in taking their photography a step further and learning about how to make art from their images, then please direct them to this workshop. Thank you.
Today we have Dallas Hayden from Yonder Image, photographer, lives in Torquay, spent 35 years doing photography with his brother John. His spouse is Amy, he has Karen, 23-month-old gorgeous little pup that I have met. His hobbies and interests include fun time with his family, music, golf, tennis, table tennis, and I can't pronounce.
Qigong.
He's been living in Torquay for the last year. He taught mathematics in schools. He's done travel photography based in Hong Kong, shooting in over 60 countries. His burning desire is to share with his family a healthy, joyful, and creative life, and to play in the over 90s. World table tennis champion. He got a little bit of time. Something no one knows about him, however, was that he holds two Australian sports titles, the under 16 boys doubles and mixed doubles in table tennis.
And you can guess who the boys doubles was with.
Yeah. Your brother's
gone.
They were just so confused they didn't know what to do.
Peter's success is a can-do attitude, openness, honesty, and humility. Dallas Hayden.
Oh, you've all met my brother John. We were sentenced to life. Our mother always said that one of us was like one person, but two of us was like two and a half. So, anyway, I'd like to have a look at the banana. You all know that this is a banana. Hands up those who would open it from this end. Okay. Hands up those who would open it from this end. Okay, well, we'll come back to that later. what's unique about John's and my photography? Okay, simple demonstration. Okay, everybody, ready to smile in about 10 seconds. I always, when I'm photographing, I'm always saying, I'll take one more, so I better take one more. Smile again. Okay, let's start. What I'll do is I'll put it on the Facebook page tomorrow.
See if you can make Robert Ringel free there.
It might be a bit hard to see you at the back. I'm saying, John and I, we're always looking for interesting angles. I feel that we're creative, we do sort of weird things and try out different things. We're two photographers, basically, pretty much for the price of one. And if people like a video, then he loves doing videos. So, also, we have a Photoshop ability. So if the pictures want to be made into pieces of art or even touched up, poles moved out of heads or... terrible marks removed, we have that ability. Over our 30 years as stock travel photographers, we've actually published three catalogues. This was the final one we did, which was called Asia and Pacific Islands. And I spent a week in China sort of retraining the printing press to make the colours as good as we could get them. And this was the last one that we produced. But it was actually came at a time when photo catalogues were going out because the internet was taking over. They became too expensive to make, even though they're, in some ways they were very beautiful because of the design and the paper and the feel of the whole production. So in that sense, we have over 10,000 images in our library, which can be used for advertising, for stock. A few examples of the uses. This one was used on Time magazine. This one was used to advertise property in the UK. See the little tiny island that John actually worked on to produce in Photoshop. But it's sort of an obscure use, but it's a property, ideal property, a little tiny island. This one was used. This one was used to advertise coffee in New York. And here's one that was used to advertise in a bodywork and massage magazine. It's actually a picture of the Maldives. And interestingly enough, John went to the Maldives in about 1983. And they've been used for many, many different uses. Here's one that was actually used, same picture of the Maldives, and it was used to advertise Caribbean cruises. So we had nothing to do with that, but that's how it resulted. Okay, here I brought along one of the pieces of artwork. We had a exhibition of 12 pieces like this in Sydney about a year and a half ago. This one's called Imagine, and it's got images, an image from Bombay in India, an image from Shanghai in China, and this one was taken in Morocco, and John worked on it, the two women in the distance and the man in the desert. This one was also in Morocco, and this one is the Opera House in Sydney, and with the construction actually came from some pieces of cranes in Lightning Ridge. And so John put them together. He comes out with these images and says, "Oh, look what I've done here." And I say, "Well, what are you doing, you know?" And this one's actually Russian dolls that sort of compress. And he's brought out the figures of the dolls. Here we have a girl doing Qigong or Tai Chi in the Black Sea in Bulgaria. And this is a small church on the Golden Ring route around Moscow, Sustal. That's actually one of our scarves that I'll talk about in a minute. This one actually, believe it or not, half of it was taken in Geelong at the merry-go-round in Geelong. The other's John's boy. So this is sort of, we did works like this. We did a 15-piece work. We've actually done a 25-piece work, which is all the way around the border. You've got another layer. And we can do that sort of to tailor make it, to customise it. Someone might have business in New York, they might have business in London, they might have business in Melbourne, and we can put together pieces to custom make the artwork. The other thing we've just started is the pure silk scarves. These are pure silk, and that one first. The original reason for starting these was because we were looking at a product that we could print on, or that would be able to be printed on, that would actually be very as good as the canvas. And actually, in some ways, the silk is a better shine than the canvas, and the canvas is as good as we can get. So we're very pleased that we could produce the silk scarves from our images. This one's the church in Sustal. And this one is Via Condotti in Rome. When you sit on the Spanish steps, you look straight down Via Condotti. And this one we actually took in about, I think, 1981, the original image. And it's able to illustrate how a photograph actually captures an instant in time. Once that time is gone, you never get the same thing again. I'll show this one. This one's pretty good. This my wife's favourite. She won't forgive me if I don't shout it right. This is the astronomical clock in Prague. And every hour, it's apparently the oldest astronomical clock in the world. And every hour, people go to the old town to watch it do its little performance. And the latest one we've done is a chiffon scarf, which is a thinner silk and also in the panoramic format. This one is actually, if anyone's been to Copenhagen, it's the fishing canal in Copenhagen called Nyhavn. Now, referrals. Actually, I came up with a lot of referrals and I didn't know what to do about them because there were so many. So I put them on a sheet and you've got it on your desk. But then I was talking to the wife and she said, oh, you have to pick out some that you think are interesting. And so what I'd say is for the bread and butter referral, something like photographing events, parties, weddings, families, children, that type of thing would be a great bread and butter referral. For the cream referral, well, we're interested in developing the scarves and we've got very little outlet for that, so something like a boutique fashion store, that sort of area would be interesting as a referral. For the dream referral would be shooting for a major airline, which is interesting because that's what we did when we started and we didn't have any money. And our mum used to joke that I don't have to worry about them. If they're hungry, they can get on a flight, right? Because we were getting the flights for free. So it's sort of like I go right back to the back. I said to my wife, I said, can I put down shooting for a major airline or travel company or resort? And she said, why not? So I thought, great. So I did. Anyway. Getting back to the banana, well, apparently the other primates other than us humans, if they don't eat the banana in one go, they choose the easiest end to peel it from, which is this end. And actually, it is easier, so. And I guess the story is that we should be open to learning from those who are skilled and have billions of years of experience.
Thanks, Alan. Great presentation. Yeah, the audience captivated the whole time, mate.
Absolutely.
That's excellent. Very, very good.